Hey guys, and welcome to Oxygen Not Included, the thermal update. Wow, season 3 has rolled around already. I've got to say, guys, I am absolutely loving this. If you guys are loving it too, why don't you let me know either down in the comments, give us a thumbs up, share this with your friends, whatever you can do to get this out here. I would be massively appreciated of it. We are starting a brand new world, a brand new rock. I mean, it's not really a world, is it? I suppose it's like a space hunk of rock thing here. And we're going to figure out a whole new crew. Let's start off by having a look at what we've got here. We've got a slow learner, but he's also got learning. He's uncultured. We might keep him. He's a bit baseline, but we might keep him. This guy here, Ada, I don't think we're going to keep you. No. I want a high athletics. Let's go through until I see that athletics pop up. I've fast clicked far too fast. Okay, bottomless stomach. I'm not loving the bottomless stomach debuff there. Okay, small bladder. I can deal with small bladder. Bladder charge is 100% per cycle. That's okay. We can just deal with that. Once again, we've got uncultured. Drop of the decor expectation. I like this. Early bird, loud sleeper. I'm never keen on loud sleepers. There's nothing quite like having someone waking all your guys up. It's terrible. Twinkle toes and flatulence, though. Okay, this is good. All boys across the board. I didn't actually intend for that to happen, but there we go. This is what we're going. And we're going for the optimistic pig pen. Love it. Let's get out there and get going. I suppose that, really, I would like to rename these guys again. But I think as with last time, yeah, I know, we have woken up in this rock. We don't know what's going on. Let's have a quick look around. I think like last time, the people that interact and really get involved are going to be the guys that get renamed here. Did I just do a weird thing? No, I didn't. Okay, so we've got water up top. We've got some oxalates. Like algae, it's looking a little bit barren. It's heavy in copper, not much else. Okay, let's get our tool out and just start digging. Now, first thing you'll notice is this thing here is different. It's the millwood seed. That's completely different. And also, there are these cracked areas here. If we let these guys go along, I do believe, and I'm still not certain, I'm going to pause this here just to say that I'm still not certain, that this is where we're going to get some of our food, some of our early game food. So let's dig this out. Come on. Any second now. Okay, someone else should go onto that. Yeah, I know people are idle, but I just want to show you some of the new things. Now, if this drops, boom, see, straightened with some muck root. This will have something behind it. This will also have something behind it. There'll be stuff everywhere. It's crazy. I don't get to select my priority on my build. What's that about? Okay, well, anyway, let's start building up here. We've got a down, we've got an up. Let's start thinking about a few things, like where are we going to put the toilet? I think the toilet belongs over this way somewhere. So I'm going to do what I normally do and make a little step up. But this time I'm going to make it a lot taller. In fact, I don't think we're even going to have a step up. I think we're just going to have a dead end here. Like normally I would put a door in that spot there, but I don't think that's going to happen today, because we're going to have a whole load of stuff to deal with. Then we can have toilets up there. So someone dealing with flatulence already. Well, that is a thing that we know we need to deal with. Yeah, we can have a toilet up there, and then we'll have sleeping quarters over here, work area in the middle-ish. I don't know. We're going to have to deal with all this water that's above me. This is where I kind of like to expand up into. I like expanding up for some reason. In fact, I can tell you exactly why I like expanding up, because that's easier to deal with the carbon dioxide when you do that. Much, much easier. Let's just dig out all of this along this way. I think probably maybe further. We're not going to end up using all this, but it's just nice to get some areas cleared out. I think I'm also going to throw a tile across here. Maybe cancel this one and put a ladder. Oh, I can't put the ladder going down yet. This will become a thing very shortly. In fact, this I'm going to make a top priority, same as digging that up. Let's watch these guys do their work. Come on, guys. Abe, Howard, and what was the other guy back here? Rowan. Abe, Rowan, and Howard are brave new duplicants. The guys that are going to go off and start a new civilization for us. This should be absolutely amazing. We're already getting to the point where we can start thinking about what we're going to do with all the plant life down here. I think I'd actually like to dig that out as well. Let's cancel that. Let these guys fix underneath here. Yeah, no, this is looking good. In fact, I'm even going to go as far as extending this up the side of the oxalite here. Yeah, yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, well, let's blitz through this a bit quicker here. We need to start thinking about where the toilet's gonna go. Do I want to put that side, or do I just want to pop it down here? So, you know what, I'm just gonna pop it down here. Do I like that? Do I not like that? I don't think I like that. I don't think I like that. The reason I don't like that is that it's gonna leave this bit open to the flow of carbon dioxide. And I kind of like to now deconstruct this and put a tile in place. Yep. Okay, like that. This is eventually probably going to become some sort of underworks. We could do with all this down here. Look at that. Blossom root seed and stuff like that. But that's all cool. I'm even going to dig all this out. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Things are looking good here. What's the next thing we need to start thinking about? It is, of course, beds. I'm going to go up a few and start across like this. This is where we're going to put our first bedroom. I have a new plan for bedrooms. It's actually just two cots like this and then a massage table in between. I used to do a massage table per cot, but it turns out that is totally overkill, like super overkill. You only ever really have like up to half your guys being stressed at any one time. So we'll try and make that a little bit more compact. The manual airlock's still not able to build one. It's kind of the next thing I want to build over this side. I want to put one here and maybe here for a little bit of containment. Containment's the word I'm looking for. Because I'd like to start getting this place sort of marked out, thinking about where things are going to go. One, two, up there. Okay, let's cancel this stuff here. And I would like to then enable the next set to go here. Apart from, I can't click in the right place. What a shocker. Okay, that there, massage table. Now this leaves room, oh, that doesn't leave room. I was gonna say this leaves room for paintings and lights at the top, but no, there is a, needs to go up one more. One, two, so painting, light, and that. Now the light is also gonna be used for things like, oh, what's going on down there? Someone doesn't seem overly happy. We have a hatch. I want to show you that the hatch do something new. If we can watch him eat something any second now, just eat something, buddy. I want to show the people. I want to show the good people that are watching along. You're not going to show them, are we? Well, anyway, he can eat this sandstone. We'll go along and kill him. And then he poops coal, which to me is amazing. That's infinite fuel, right? What's happened here? Polluted water. Have we had a toilet mishap already? Okay, let's do it here. Let's do it here. Let's get this 9 down. One on this side, one on this side, and then room for a composting heap in the middle. I'm also going to do a sweep. I was too worried about the beds. What I should have got worried about was, of course, the toilet. Can we take all that out as well? It's looking good, looking good. Get the priority machine out. Let's start this. Nines. Maybe 9 was not the strength I wanted to go on. Let's go for an 8 so that the mopping takes a higher precedent than the building. We have unrefrigerated food. That is fine as we stand at the moment. At some point, we're going to have to get like power and research and all those sorts of good things on the go. They're still digging out the wall, despite the fact that I've put this as a much higher priority. I'm going to assume it's because I've not put this going out far enough. So let's do that. Let's pull this up. One of these here. One of these here. Move this ladder all the way up. I'm not sure how far we're going to go, but you know, that's a good start. I'm going to start thinking about where we're going to put things across here. Like, I would really like to dig all this out as well. I think that's a thing I want to do. Is this oxalite? This is also oxalite. Okay. Ah, yes. People going on for the bedroom. Do I want to put another bed there? We could get all three beds on the same level. It'll be a little bit cramped. In fact, I think I'd like to rearrange the placement of all this stuff. Let's have a look in here. The cot, I'd like to move there, and then the cot, let's put it here. Okay, that feels a little bit better. It's not great. I think I would have preferred it to be one further so we could have a gap in between everything, and then, you know, that would have all worked out fine. Let's get the dig on. Are these guys getting their dig on? They are getting their dig on. It's just not quite as efficient as I would like it to be. Okay, yeah, this is all good. I'm always so dubious about taking out the oxalite. Really, it just needs to be dug out, but I like to have it around. I'm not sure. Like, I know once you drop it to the floor, if you do dig it and don't store it away. It will still, like, leak oxygen, if you will. Okay, one thing I'm going to do is prioritize these top layers over the top of the next layers down, because these guys can quite easily get stuck by digging out the lower layers and not being able to dig out the top layers. Maybe making them a 9 was a little much. Let's let that fall. Let's let that fall. That'll be fine. I was going to try and dig out that again. Let's get it on the 6. Let's do it. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to have this here. I think what I'd like to do is maybe have a line of tiles going across the top here. This space is being saved for algae terrarium. And indeed, 1, 2, 3. I think I've left a little bit too much room. So I'm going to double this up here. They're all falling. I love it when you just catch them at the last moment. Now, okay, let's slow our game back down. Start thinking about some of the things we need to put down. I think... Am I going to do this? Am I going to dig? I am. I'm going to dig over the top of the oxalite. We're gonna do that. That looks brilliant. Do we want this here? You know what? I was going to double this up, but I think what I actually want is to put a ladder down this way, and then suddenly it's like all super accessible and things like that. The toilets are being used. Let's get up to rhino speed rather than that plodding along pace. So, the whole sort of basis for food has changed. It used to be that you could keep a muckroot population on the go. Yes, you can, but you need to keep finding more muckroot. They don't drop seeds at the end of their growth cycle anymore. But these things here, bristle blossoms, they do. They do drop the seeds at the end of their growth cycle. Do we want to just kind of dig all this out? No, I don't want to dig that out. That's just going to give us a lot of stuff that I want to deal with. What I really want to do is get all this done. So I'm going to crank those up to an 8. We're going to have a look at the... What do I want? I wanted the power. That's what I wanted. We're going to put a manual generator there. For now, we're going to put a battery here, but this will move. It's not the best place to keep things like batteries. It will end up heating the area around it, which it's livable. It's livable. You know what? Actually, we're going to cancel that build. I'm going to put something else there, and I think we're going to put our battery right here. It's a little distance away. I would have probably preferred to not have it like that. Let's do this, and then I'm going to put another one up there like that, because I want to go nuts, and you guys might think this is crazy, but I'm going to put a double research station down. Oh yeah, let's really push the boat out and make sure we can get our sciences done nice and quickly. There are a few early researches that I really want to make sure we get done nice and quickly. Okay, so I'm having a look at the oxalite on the floor, and you can see it is... Wow, it disappeared. But we can see that it's, like, still letting loose all its oxygen, just not quite in the same controlled manner that this oxalite will be. Do we have access to any more? Like, we could dig through here and let this out. That would be cool. I'm going to eventually put sort of an oxygen processing area here. There'll be, like, a gas pump, and the vents will come out and lead all around. And then we'll have either the algae or the... electrolysis machine here, depending on what level of tech we're at. And I do hear there are other ways of getting resource. So is this what I think it is? No, there are new biomes available. Here we go. This one is the one I'm looking for. This is a cold biome. Look, there's snow everywhere. It's liquefiable. It does unfortunately liquefy down there. They're polluted ice. So we've got snow and polluted ice. The polluted ice, if you couldn't tell, is contaminated ice. So we got to watch out for that. I'm also looking out for where our source of bleach stone might possibly be, but I don't see it immediately around. Look, we got one of these guys. So I want to do a lot more playing with the animals in this season. We've got puffs. We've got hatches. Now, the puffs taking contaminated oxygen, or polluted oxygen, sorry, still talking in last update's parlance. They taking polluted oxygen and drop slime. Let's see, what does it say? Puffs rid itself of the excess pathogens by excreting lumps of slime with each breath. So they say, but I don't see any actually being dropped. So I don't know if anything's going wrong with that. The hatches, as I say, they eat minerals and excrete coal. And of course, we know the morbs produce contaminated oxygen. Now, I'd like to get a morb and a puffed in the same room and see what happens with that. But I'm not sure how that works. Okay, first thing, farming. I would like everybody to get full on the novice research production. That and this. Come on, let's do that. Also, it's time to start prioritizing these jobs. I know, crazy. We're going to put a 7 on the power, 6 on the research. Did I just hit 7s there? I did. I wanted to click 6. I'm fairly sure I actually clicked the button, but wasn't having it for some reason. And now up at the 7s, I'm also going to start digging this area out. Now, that's going to be slightly more important than the research, but that's fine. That's fine. As soon as that's dug out, I'm actually going to dig out this next layer, but as soon as both of those are dug out, they should be able to get back, and we should start getting our farming tech on the go. I'm now wondering where we're going to do the farming. Maybe actually here is a good spot for the farm. Yeah, maybe. We could put little layers of tile, that's the word I'm looking for, in. Yeah, okay, I'm getting a little picture here. We'll have a door, and then different layers coming out with all the farm stuff on it. Perhaps one on either side with a ladder and an oxygen grate on the inside. Yeah, that works for me. Let's do that. So on a 6, we're also going to do this. New duplicant is needed. Well, new duplicant is ready, and we do indeed require one. So let's have a look. Mole hands and flatulence, not so going for that. To be honest, now that I'm looking across, the mole hands and flatulence might actually be the best one. Because it's a digger, and they just fart a little bit. That's fine, we can live with that. The mouth breather uses more oxygen. No. And the biohazard gets sick everywhere. No. Okay, so let's get Devon. How you doing, buddy? Welcome to the team. I hope you're going to have a good time. If you want to go around and fix everything up, that would be great. I'm going to put this on a 9 because you know that I want to make sure that all my food is tidied up. And at some point, we're going to make a nice little storage area, and we're going to do the same with that. We're going to make sure that everything is a 9 on that so that the floor keeps clean. There's nothing quite as bad. In fact, let me show you. If we go to the decor and zoom in here, you can see that the debris on the floor is giving us a minus 83. Minus 83. That is ridiculous. Okay, third night into it, everything seems to be working out well. We've got oxygen flow going well. All the researchers are going down, and these guys are now building the nice little farm area that I talked about. We are still waiting for the actual research. These guys are going to take it up to 19, and then someone can just push it over the edge. So that'll be nice and good. There, are we gonna get this going, guys? Come on, we can do this. Extra. Oh wait, can we go even faster? We can go even faster! Do it! Oh yeah! Get this sciencing done, and then everything should be alright. So that's a research. Was that all of it? That sounded like all of it. So there's a few things I need to go around. Yeah, look, we got extra stuff here. I'm not bothered about these yet, in fact. We want those there. I'm going to put those on a massively high priority at some point. Planter boxes want to go like here and here, here and here. Here, okay, we'll work that through. And then the next thing and the final thing from that particular bit of research is to get the compost down. So if we can get all these things done, we will be on the cutting edge of research. I'm gonna then wait for the to get these guys going for the next level research until all this gets done, because I'd like to do things like get this compost. This compost is a pretty high priority, because if we don't get this done, the polluted dirt, I can't remember. Yeah, polluted dirt will just get thrown on the floor from here. Yeah, maybe periodically empty the polluted dirt. There we go. So that's what this compost is for. It gives us fertilizer. Now, the fertilizer last update did absolutely naffle. There was no point in having it at all. But now, with the advent of the bristle blossoms, is that what they were called? Bristle blossom, yeah, being so... they need fertilizer. That's the word I was looking for. They really need fertilizer. I'm going to build a ladder up here and a ladder down here. And then we got room for sort of the oxygen system in the middle. I'm even going to go as far, maybe not a 9, but go as far as to put another line in. I'm going to go across. I'm going to go all the way across. This is not going to be enough to survive on. We'll eventually have to extend this out and go further. What do we have here? Bristle blossoms on that side. Let's put some millwood on this side. The millwood turns over a lot faster. So the more of that we can keep going, at least in these early stages, the better. Algae terrariums, they are a number 9 priority. No, that's a sweep. Was that a sweep? I'm not sure. The algae terrariums, top priority, because we need to keep our CO2 scrubbed. Let's have a look. Scrub. So this should make it all A-okay. Eventually, after a little bit of time. They don't really appear. What are we missing? Water? Oh. I had not considered... This is the second time I've done this in as many playthroughs. Okay, let's think about this. How are we going to get up here and start emptying this out? What I'd really like to do is start thinking about digging all this out and dropping it down here somewhere. Should we do a thing? I'm going to do a thing. I'm going to put this up at 9, and I want it to go all the way through... Yes. I'm considering whether this is a bad idea or not. I'm starting to think maybe it is. But then if we tile 9, let me just make sure we get this right. There's that, and the space. So I actually want to put this in all the way across there. Not sure about these end ones here. Let's prioritize, bring this down to a 7. These will get changed. We're going to expand. We're going to do some other things. So everything's going to move. So those guys are all digging and doing their work. That's cool. Someone's going to come up and do stuff there. I really want this done. I also saw... Yes, there was. I want to make these an 8. Okay, so as we dig through, these will take priority over the hole that gets made. So that's pretty good. You guys appear to be having a little bit of trouble here. What can we do about this? What we're going to do is we're going to cancel these, and we're going to dig this, and we're going to see if they can make their way down. No. Okay, we're going to have to break this and this and just let them fall. There we go. Now they can go around and do what they need to do. Let's fill that back in and wait and see. What are they going to do? Oh, look, already they require a fertilizer. That's fine. That, I thought that was going to be like too little atmospheric pressure there. I was going to be like, no. Let's pull these down here. We are just about to let a whole load of water through, so this should be fun, as they say. Do we want to dig all this lot up? I think we do, actually. You see everything from like here to here. I'd like that to get dug. Good dog. Oh, yeah. It's taken a while to dig, but the diggers are good. Let's have a look at our jobs up here. Is there anyone doing stuff that they shouldn't be doing? Well, for starters, everyone's doing art, and that's terrible. But thankfully, we haven't put stuff up. Let's take these guys off of power. How are the diggers doing? They're just generally all pretty bad at digging. And I've also noticed, wow, look at all this open. Okay, the big thing that this update was all about was, of course, the temperature. Oh, look, here, you saw it, he ate a resource and pooped out coal. So the big thing about this update was, of course, the temperature. Here is the temperature overlay. Generally, we're doing quite nice. We're quite warm at the moment. This can become an issue where we get over warm, but I don't think it's that much of a problem. And we are slowly melting all this ice. It's minus 19. Why is it melting? Why aren't you... Maybe the impurities make it a lower boiling point or something like that. Lower melting point. Whatever the word is. You know what I'm trying to say here. Okay, we're finally down to actually having water. And I would like this to get going up here. I'm not sure like how fast we can push them through it. I'm a little bit worried that I don't get as much done during a day when I'm at full speed. It just feels like they don't get as much done over the various playthroughs that I've done. I feel like more gets done if you go through the day slowly. As I say, I think that's probably more mental than anything. But if you guys have noticed a similar thing, let me know. You may be wondering why I've left these whacking holes in between the manual generator here. These are all going to get ripped up eventually. These are just to get the first level of tech for me. And then I'm going to have 3 manual generators with permeable tiles underneath, pushing all its carbon dioxide down to the algae terrarium. That should keep us all nicely topped up with oxygen. Oh, people are on their way. Devon is building his construction skills. Hopefully now with the... like exposed face, more people should be able to come along and get this stuff done. We can see Rowan is coming to stick his face in. I think we need somewhere to put all the seeds. Let's get a storage compactor on the go. I'm going to put this here. Maybe we'll have more planter boxes down below. Yeah, we'll have all 3 tiers filled up. That should be wonderful. Rowan, if you could. Rowan and Howard both coming along to do the work here. Obviously, putting the ladder in takes a little bit more effort. And to be honest, we didn't need to go all the way up with the ladders. We could easily have left these top 2 off. Oh, it tells me there's insufficient oxygen being produced. So what I might do, just for now, and it really is just for now, I'm going to pop this here. We're going to rip this down probably next episode as we start to expand. But today's episode is going to wrap up with the great flood that we're trying to set up here. Let's get that dug out as well. In fact, this needs to be a much higher priority dig. And then hopefully people come along and be all over making... Yeah, look at this. Straight away, they're into making... the tiles here. That's good, proper, and the way things should be. I'm wondering if we're going to run into any hatches or anything like that. I'm not sure. There is a dig pending here. No, nothing alive appears to be hassling me here. Oh, look, their dig guns have got this lovely sort of enchanted purple look to them. And then the builds are yellow. It's crazy how the different jobs have different guns depending on what goes on. But... I think maybe the dig depends, the colour of the gun depends on what they're digging. Does it go that deep? Look, this guy, yellow on the copper, now they're coming into, it's yellow on the coal as well. I'm not sure what pulls out the different coloured guns. Let's wait until they get to some, there's no sandstone here. It's all just like consumable ore and metal. That's a little bit of a shame, but the flood is about to start. I'm going to get this over on an 8 as well. I'd like that to get dug out. Here we go, it's going to start. Now, I know that there is some dodgy interaction with ladders. Are we not flooding? Is that not what's going on? I was kind of hoping for a bit of a flood. No? Is that not allowed? Just flow? Maybe this is cold and sort of sluggish. Could really do with it all just kind of dripping down, though. I mean, it is, slowly. But that's so slow. Too slow. Some might say too slow. I definitely say too slow. I assume it's because this is too small a gap. What can we do about that? What can we do? It's fine. They're doing stuff about it already. I love these guys. They just come around and do all the jobs that need doing. With oh, not nighttime already. Okay, next day, day 6. Let's see what we can get underway. Now, obviously, we have some... oxygen problem, so let's make that a priority here. Everyone's gone around and put in these millwoods. Atmospheric pressure too low. That is definitely something we're going to have to address in the next episode. In fact, I'm going to start addressing it straight away. Do we want to do it with the gas piping? We're going to do it with the gas piping. We'll see what we can do about that at some point. Now, these should be a fairly low priority. Yes, they are. So we can come along and dig all that stuff out. And now, hopefully, all the water is going to flow a good one. I don't like the fact that it's only dripping off this edge. I kind of was hoping for a bit more of a flood. You know what I'm saying? It could have done with going a lot faster. I'm even going to go up here and dig out these areas. Let's just clear all the water that's just a little bit in my way. There we go. That should make everything A-okay. This wants to be seeds on a 9. Hopefully someone will go around and pick up all those seeds. This is super important, though. Super, super important. Someone farted. It's funny in real life and in games as well. Perhaps what we actually want to do, let's do a dig down the side here. Because one thing I have noticed is if you do these digs either side, everything kind of gets exposed, and then more duplicants can get at the jobs, if you see what I'm saying. And then hopefully it will also open up a big floodgate here. It's not wanting to flow past this area for some reason. It can't be the briar seed, can it? I mean, it could be, but I don't think it should be. Let's put a 9 there. Wait. He's drowning. Should we just let him drown? There we go. He drowned. Look at that. Brilliant. That's the thing. We can let creatures drown in water. Okay. Perhaps we could use that to euthanize some dupes at some point. Because later on, they're going to get, like, super picky, right? Super, super picky. These guys don't know how to get out of here, do they? Do they? Where are you going? I'm not sure. Yes, they do. Okay, we've got to wait for this all to drain now, and that is going to be a lot of effort. But I am going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you next time. We're going to build that little oxygen room that I talked about, so we can get the atmospheric pressure up here. We can pump some gases out this way. We're going to start thinking about a mess hall and more power, more science, more everything. But I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye!